Hello, 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 everybody.
Hello.
Everybody in the house?
Yes, sir.
Everybody in the house?
Yeah.
Everybody in the house?
Yeah.
When we fight?
We win.
When we fight?
We win.
When we fight?
We win.
All right, we're going to do a little something here. We're going to start out our chanting. We're going to do a little practice here real quick. We have this by numbers, so when I say number one, everybody get to number one, so you don't have to be looking for it. All right, if I say number 15, we jump to 15. All right?
Yes, yes, we say numero uno.
And
outside, la consigna numero uno. Y si dice 15, vamos a usar la consigna 15. ¿Entienden?
Okay.
All right. Freddie Mac? Freddie Mac?
What number?
Number one, sorry. I blew my own cover, man. Went back to the old style. Forgive me for that, right? Bad habit. All right. We have a new style now. We're going to do the numbers.
Okay.
All right, number one. Freddie Mac, Freddie Mac, Mel Watt, you can hide. We can see your greedy side. Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, Mel Watt, you can hide, we can see your greedy side. One, two, three, four, no more constables at our door. Five, six, seven, eight, don't evict, negotiate. One, two, three, four, no more constables at our door. Five, six, seven, eight, don't evict, negotiate. One, two, three, four, no more constables at our door. Five, six, seven, eight, don't evict, negotiate.
One, two, three, four.
All right, we'll do number 15. Whose homes? Our homes.
Whose city?
Our streets. Whose city? Our city. Whose homes?
Our homes.
Whose streets?
Our streets.
Whose city?
Our city.
Whose homes?
Our homes.
Whose city?
Our city.
Up with the people?
Yeah, yeah.
Down with the banks?
Boom, boom.
Up with the people?
Yeah, yeah.
Down with the banks?
Boom, boom.
Up with the people?
Yeah, yeah.
Down with the banks?
Boom, boom.
What do we want?
Affordable housing.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Affordable housing.
When do we want it?
Now.
Housing is for people, not for profit.
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 I've been told.
I don't know what I've been told.
Fannie Mae's been stealing homes.
Fannie Mae's been stealing homes.
So we are here today to prove.
So we are here today.
Shall not be removed.
We shall not be moved.
I don't know, but I've been told.
I don't know, but I've been told.
Fannie Mae been stealing homes.
Fannie Mae's been stealing homes.
So we are here today to prove.
So we are here today to prove.
We shall not be removed.
We shall not be removed.
Sound off.
Sound off.
Sound off.
We stand up and we fight for what is ours. We're not going to lay down
not let them take nothing from us. We are tired of it, and it's time for a change. And we don't want the change tomorrow. We want it now. We want to win
now.
We want to win
now.
Yes, we do. We don't want to wait till tomorrow. We might not be here. But today we are. So we're fighting. And I ain't giving up the fight until I'm on the other side of the ages.
We will stand and fight with you.
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 Yeah, I ain't going anywhere.
That is great. And we will stand and fight with you until the end.
And we will
block the eviction. If Fanny is wanting to come to evict you, we will block it. Know that as a community, we are strong and we have voices. Yeah. We have rights as well. Yeah. And housing is a right. It's a people right. This is number one human.
Okay.
We need, what can you say?
Food and shelter. We need,
exactly. This is our right. And then you put your money in it, they knew you probably gonna fail. They fail you from the beginning, took your money and wanna run with it, and they think that's gonna go on for free. No. It's not gonna happen this way. We will stand and fight until the end. I'm gonna tell you my story, okay? The same thing happened to me back in 2010. Because of this community, because of Springfield, no one lives, we all fought together, and I was able to win my house, and I'm still in my house, bought it back from Fannie Mae. This is the people power. We have to show that we have the last word, not them. They're not going to tell us what to do. We need to tell them what they need to do for us. Not being bullied around that, saying that they have to decide for us. Don't we have voices?
Yes.
They should not decide for us. We need to decide for ourselves.
Yes. No.
If we want to stay, we're not going to go anywhere. And Jeff wants to stay, and he's going to stay here with everybody. Everybody's going to stay with Jeff. You gotta come in and drag us all from this house. We're gonna chain ourselves here. No one's leaving. We're all gonna come in and live in this house. And this is our home, and it's our city, and it's our country, and it's our town. We met you over there. We voted for you to be over there. You need to do what's right for us, not what's wrong for us. Please, you gotta listen. With everything we did, and you, Mel, okay, what we did, we thought you're gonna change. You got there and changed your mind. You think that we're gonna let you just sit like this? It's not gonna happen, okay? It's not gonna, we all gonna fight until the end, okay? Everybody, I wanna thank everybody that's here to fight with us.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I speak in Spanish.
Okay.
He's my translator.
Okay.
Yo estoy aquí para que sepan que yo en mi infancia viví una experiencia en la que mi mamá tuvo que invadir una casa en Puerto Rico. Yo soy puertorriqueña, yo vengo de Puerto Rico.
So today I'm here to tell a story. I'm here to tell the story of my childhood, where my mom had a squat in a home when I was a kid in Puerto Rico, because I'm from Puerto Rico.
Para ese tiempo, en Puerto Rico habían terrenos desocupados, viviendas desocupadas, y mi mamá era una persona que tenía cuatro hijas y no tenía dónde pasar la noche con nosotras.
So at that time, there was a lot of vacant land, there was a lot of vacant homes, and my mom had to take care of four daughters, and she had nowhere to go.
Es fácil para el que tiene vivienda mirar al que está desamparado como si fueran deambulantes, vagabundos, personas que quieren conseguir las cosas fáciles, y esa no es la realidad de la vida.
So for people who have a home, it's really easy to judge a homeless person and call them bums and, you know, just people with no dignity. But you don't know until you experience it.
Pues mi mamá se enteró por medio de una persona que en una urbanización en el pueblo de Sidra había una casa desocupada y le dijo, no pase más noches con tu hija por la calle. Métete en esa casa. Y lo único que puede pasar es pues que el gobierno te saque, pero no vas a estar en la calle con tus hijas. Y mi mamá se armó de fuerza y valentía y dijo, vengan niñas, que aquí tenemos donde vivir, tenemos un techo. Y nos metimos las cinco en esa casa e invadimos esa casa.
So my mom found out that in Sidra, a region, an urban area in Puerto Rico, she found out that there was a vacant home. And my mom was brave, and we all moved in, the five of us. And you know, what was the worst thing that could happen? We would be evicted, but at least we would have a place to live for those days.
Para mí fue una experiencia muy bonita porque a pesar de que la casa no tenía luz ni agua, en la parte de atrás tenía una piscina bien grande y pues nosotros pues utilizábamos esa agua para los usos mientras estuviésemos en la casa. Y a la misma vez, yo recuerdo que yo tenía 7 años y yo lo que hice fue que yo le dije a los vecinitos de la comunidad, vengan, métanse en la piscina. Si echan una monedita y cae dentro de este envase, se pueden tirar. Si no cae, pues no se tiran. Y así yo aprendí a ganarme el dinero también.
So for me, it was a beautiful experience. Even though we didn't have water, we didn't have electricity, but we had a swimming pool in the back. And you know, we used the swimming pool as our water for the house. But I also learned that I could organize the little kids in the neighborhood, and I could put a cup at the end, at the deep side, and tell the kids to throw their coins in there. And if they got the coin inside the cup, they could jump inside the pool. And so for me, that was just a wonderful experience.
Y resulta que después de nosotros haber vivido así, pues entonces el gobierno vio a mi mamá como una persona que es capaz de invadir un territorio y habitarlo por necesidad. Y dijo, pues espérate, que a esta señora tenemos que darle una vivienda para ella y sus hijas. Y así fue como mi mamá pudo conseguir una vivienda para tenernos con un techo a nosotros. Porque el gobierno vio que ella era una persona que se atrevía a lo que sea por no tener sus hijos en la calle. Y de esa forma tenemos que hacernos todos nosotros aquí y hasta los que no tengan hijos, tenemos que atrevernos a luchar y a demostrarle al gobierno que nosotros somos personas necesitadas de un techo.
So what ended up happening was the government ended up finding out. And what happened was the government saw that my mom was a woman willing to do anything to put a shelter for her children. And it was that need that forced the government to help my mom in getting housing. And so here at Springfield No One Leaves, and here, we should be brave enough. We should show that we need a place to live and that we're willing to do anything, whether we have children or not, to obtain housing for all.
También quiero dejarles saber que les traigo esa experiencia vivida porque pues nosotros tenemos que pelear y luchar contra Fannie Mae, contra cualquier monstruo que se nos presente en el medio. Porque ellos no son los dueños de la tierra, ellos no son los dueños del territorio. Nosotros también necesitamos tierra, necesitamos techo donde dormir y nosotros tenemos que luchar unidos para lograrlo. unidos podemos lograr todo.
So today, we at Springfield No One Leaves need to fight. And we need to fight against anyone who gets in our way, whether it's Fannie Mae or anyone else. Right. Oh, because none of these people or organizations or companies are the owners of the land. They're not owners of this territory.
That's right.
And that we deserve a piece of that. And so we need to fight for it.
Right. Yeah.
And united we could do it.
Right.
And united we could fight for anything.
Otra cosa que les quiero decir también. Esa fue mi experiencia vivida en Puerto Rico. Yo aquí en Springfield le hice un acercamiento a una persona que todavía el gobierno no le ha dado vivienda y es padre de familia.
So that was my story, and I've told a gentleman with a child about Springfield No One Leaves.
Y yo le dije a él que ahora mismo él está luchando para que le den vivienda y todavía está viviendo en casa ajena. Yo le digo, si tú ves una casa que está vacía y le pertenece al gobierno, tú te atreves a invadir esa vivienda para darle un techo a los hijos tuyos si estás en esa necesidad. Y él me dijo que no.
And so here, I spoke with this gentleman, and I asked him, well, while you're homeless, if you see a vacant home and it's owned by the government, would you take it? And this person said no.
Porque él dice, yo no me atrevo a hacer una cosa así porque esa casa a mí no me pertenece y si me llevan preso. Y ahí fue que yo le hablé de mi experiencia. Y yo le dije, yo vivía en una casa invadida. Mi mamá la invadió, a mi mamá no se la llevaron presa, al contrario. Le dieron un hogar para su familia. ¿Por qué? Porque si uno tiene hijos, uno se tiene que atrever a lo que sea, a todo. ¿Cómo si tú tienes hijos durmiendo en la calle, tú no te vas a atrever a coger una casa que esté vacía y darle un techo a los hijos tuyos? ¿Por miedo a quién? ¿Y por miedo a qué? No tenemos que temerle a nada.
And so I kept, you know, talking to him, and I pushed him. I said, look, this is my story. My mom dared to do this, and she was able to get housing. So you should do the same. We shouldn't be afraid of anyone. We shouldn't be afraid of obtaining housing for children.
Arise to speak. Merci beaucoup.
Hi, I'm Ellen from Arise for Social Justice, and we're here to fight with everybody else. We believe strongly that everybody should have a home, and it's not up to the big businesses, it's not up to the banks to say no. They have no right to have the houses. We have the houses.
Right. Yes.
And if we stand together as No One Leaves and Arise has stood together through a long time now of just brothers and sisters, if we all stand together and fight, we can stop the banks from claiming homes.
Right.
And the homes are for the people,
right.
not for banks, not to be boarded up, not to just walk by. They're for the people, and the people should have them. We've got to get the banks to say, we'll sell you the house for low prices. They don't have to make $1 million. We have to get the banks to say, this is your house. We're not coming for it. We'll negotiate with you. We'll say, help you. will even let you pay back what you owe. That makes sense?
Yes.
And that banks need just to be people, because the banks are made up of people.
Right.
So they should let it be standing with us out here.
Right.
So let's fight together.
Woo!
Yeah.
This is your city.
Right.
You go all around Trinity, you see all these homes are being brought up, you know, bringing the mayor. The mayor. Shame on you. You should be right here fighting with us. It's your city and our city. But you know, you say something and you don't implement it. You put how do you call it again? What did we win again?
An ordinance.
And you didn't implement it because you're afraid of the bank. Shame on you. Shame on you. Shame on you. The mayor. Shame on you!
For the mayor. Who are we looking for?
The mayor.
Who are we looking for?
The mayor.
Who are we looking for?
Greetings from Maple, the Mass Alliance Against Predatory Lending, the statewide coalition, and I wanted to back you up by saying Springfield may have been the first folks to pass pre-foreclosure mediation. We've been, you know, working on this legislation around the state. Lynn has implemented pre-foreclosure mediation.
All right.
In court trying to fight this, trying to undo what we all know we have a right to, but Lynn went ahead and implemented anyway, and Worcester is right now in the midst of hiring its mediation outfit, and it should be up and running sometime in the next month or month and a half as well. So Springfield, you're falling behind, Joe Springfield city government. It's time to catch up. I also want to bring some other very good news. Our neighbors to the east and south of Massachusetts, Rhode Island has now got tenant protections for former tenants to be able to stay and rent while the banks own their property, just like we do here in Massachusetts. They stood on our shoulders. They just won this a week ago. A lot of us just got news today. This is a big win. Let's make not only Massachusetts safe for homeowners, let's not only get our rights back here, let's not only turn Fannie around and the trusts and all the folks who have illegally pillaged our neighborhoods and our homes and our cities and towns, but let's get all of New England with us and let's turn the whole ship. Enough. They're sitting on trillions of yours and my dollars. The time has come for us to turn this around. Thank you.
Anyone? Oh, great. Thank you.
All right, thanks. I just want to say we're in solidarity with Jeff Sullivan, and we want to make sure that our coalition here is here to support Jeff and Springfield No One Leaves and the Bank Tenants Association. The same issues that are affecting, you know, the fact that we have so many foreclosures and banks are preying on working class people is also the same that we're seeing with large corporations preying on low-wage workers. The continuing attack against public education. These are all, you know, fights that are all intersecting. They're all things we have to fight together. We have to find ways to build our movement, and that's so important to see so many people out here today showing that we're building community around these different issues that connect us, no matter what it is. We have to be here for Jeff and be here for Springfield No One Leaves, so I'm just happy to be here, and we got to continue to fight for the working class. Thank you.
Thanks.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Jacques. I live right here. That's my house.
All right, Jacques.
And I'm happy to see so many people come here to support Jeff. Tonight is Jeff. Tomorrow is going to be me.
Right.
Because nobody in this situation, in this economy we live in, nobody. It's gonna be you tomorrow. Don't. I hope nobody left because Jeff has decided over here. It's a serious situation over here. We can sleep at night because we don't know it. No, but tomorrow, she's gonna be knocked at our door.
Right, that's true.
And I'm glad I see so many people, and I'm happy to meet so many people to support Jeff because I'm gonna need. This you two people here next week. I'm not the same boat with them. And I'm gonna need you next week. Thank you very much.
I'm coming from this event. I used to live in the Leopard area, and it's not as serious where a bank is taking my house. It's more of an issue where a landlord, I was staying at a place for 2 months, and they kind of just wanted to just cut me off, and I got arrested for breaking and entering and trespassing in my own house, and all my property is still there. And it's the first time in my life. I'm 29 years old, and I've been homeless for the past 3 weeks. And all my life, I've always, like, you know, you don't know until you experience it yourself, and then just the injustice of just the power that certain people have, and just nonchalantly not caring about the most serious situations. And when you think about the infrastructure of a city like this, and when people don't have houses to go inside and get off of the streets, that's why there's violence in the streets, and that's why there's crime. So at the basis of the infrastructure of a society, housing is the simplest things that can reduce crime and violence and just drugs. And the fact that those people just don't care is wrong. And these are beautiful things like this that make them so mad. You know what I mean? It's just like us coming together like this makes those people so mad. You know, they're in their bars, like, drinking themselves to death because we're standing together like this. And it's what they don't want. So just keep on fighting, you know?
Oh, we here to fight?
Yeah.
We here to fight with Jeff and his family?
Yeah.
All right. When will we fight?
We win.
When we fight?
We win.
When we fight?
We win.
All right, let's do it then. I'm here with my two daughters, usually three of them, and we've been fighting for the last 3 years. And you know how we do it. We fight with family, we fight with community, we stay strong, we stay united. Well, I'm proud to say that, you know, in the courts, we won our fight. But Fannie Mae and Mel Watts are still playing games with us. They're still not, we're still in limbo here. I live in my house with my children, still in limbo, not sure what's gonna happen to us. Like Jeff, they could start this whole process with me again. Tomorrow I could be the one facing eviction. So as your community, people that live in this community or people who are part of the community as a whole, stay aware and alert what's going on. Okay, we have to stay together.
Yeah.
I was honored a few months ago to go down and represent Springfield in the Northeast and talk to Mel Watts. And Mel Watts' answer to all our demands was, the report card, he's gonna come out with this report card, and this report card's gonna address all our demands. But I'm gonna tell you, if Mel Watts is listening, anyone who has his number or any media that's here, get the message to Mel Watts. I got your report card, and you effed us all. And you gotta F all across the board.
Right.
All right? Because people like Jeff should not be still wondering what's gonna go on with this house, still facing eviction. Okay? And let me repeat what our demands are, just in case he forgot. Give loan modifications with principal reductions immediately.
Immediately.
Okay? Our houses, we can sell our houses to investors for half the cost. We can sell it to anybody, but we won't work with the family members that are still in their homes trying to be a part of the community. Come on, how disgusting is that?
Protect Americans.
Protect Americans. Protect the community. Protect our livelihood. Sell back homes after foreclosure to previous homeowners and tenants. Okay? Now, we've been dealing with the BS from the bank for far too long now. And they've been telling us that they're not going to, they're going to punish us. Or they're going to punish, they don't want to deal with us because they want to encourage bad behavior. What about your bad behavior? Huh? Your bad behavior continues to pile on to us poor homeowners who are trying to do the right things by our families and by our communities. Come on now, do right by us. Accept rent. Okay, at the very least, okay? Accept our rent. Take the money. You're good at that. Take the money. Accept our rent. Tonight we're here to make it clear. Tonight we're here to make it clear. You must fund the National Housing Trust. They withheld almost $1 billion $1 billion from the National Trust Fund.
Right.
Come on now. Turn these homes into affordable rental properties.
Right.
We need it here in community.
Yeah. That's right.
The homeless crisis is growing. It's not getting better. It's getting worse.
Yeah.
We got vacant homes all over the place, but we're just boarding them up.
Right.
An eyesore to our community, to our children. An invitation for crime.
Right.
Let's put
some people in these houses and build our communities back again.
Right.
Come on now.
Right.
Right. Right.
David.
So tonight we're here as a community to stand strong with Jeff. I brought my two daughters, Mariam and Kalima, Mariam and Daphne. And
as you know,
they are singers. And so they're going to sing us into a match. After they're done, we're going to follow Roberto, the people with the yellow. We're going to start hitting all the vacant homes in the area. All right? But you get that spirit up now. Come on now. When we fight,
we win.
When we fight,
we win.
When we fight,
we win.
For Jeff. Let's fight for Springfield. Let's fight for Massachusetts. This is a song of hope, okay? We want to raise up the hope of our community. We want to raise up the hope of Jeff. We want to raise up the hope of Springfield. So our girls are going to set us off. Come on, girls.
No father figure in the house, and I'm wondering how I'm going to work it out. Oh, my friends keep on telling me that I don't need that man, but they don't really understand. There's far too many pressures in reality, dealing with the pain, the stress, and poverty. And I gotta be myself because there's nobody else for me, no. Sometimes you need a different kind of love to raise a child, so don't give up. My pressures come down. Sometimes it takes a different kind of dream to make a smile. So raise. Sometimes we need another helping hand to show the way. So don't give up when pressures come down. Sometimes it seems impossible. That's why we pray. We pray. Seems to be none left for me. Mama's gone, daddy didn't want to be. And now I'm all by myself. Life falls down on me, cuts into my soul. But I know I got the strength to make it through it all. Cause I'm still standing tall, breaking through these walls. I'm gonna give it my all. Feeling like a motherless child,
And that's our home.
Look it up. Listen up.
Could you tell me your name?
My name is Jeff Salton.
And Jeff, so what's happening with your house?
Right now my house is it's been foreclosed on, and the courts have given the house Fannie Mae has the house, but Fannie Mae wants me to be removed from my home. They don't want to make any kind of deals with me to make it an affordable housing or sell it back to me at a decent price, you know. And it's sad because now I'm in court facing eviction, and for use and occupancy of my house right now, they want $850 a month until my appeal goes through, because I appealed the decision of the court.
Yeah.
And it's so sad that they know I only get $700-something a month. I'm on a fixed income of SSI. And they're willing to put me out in my in the streets like they have done everybody else, then to make that house an affordable rental where I can actually keep the property up on the house so that it doesn't become one of these houses that are boarded up or vacant and has been damaged, and the pipes have been removed, and whatever else has gone wrong with the house. This house here has a lot of mold, mildew, and everything in it, and it's just falling apart in the back and everything. It's ridiculous. It's really ridiculous.
Especially when we know that so many people don't even have housing and would love to have a house that they could live in.
That's right. And you know what the sad thing about it is? There are more empty homes than there are homeless people. What's wrong?
What is wrong? Thank you, Jeff.
When is America going to be America? I was born in America. I never turned my backs on you guys when you needed me. Why you turn your backs on me now? Remember my forefathers? We're Native American. We're Indian. You remember when you took our land then? Now you're taking our land again.
We're standing to fight with you.
And I thank you for standing to fight.
It's another home that's been foreclosed in this lovely neighborhood. And the neighbors all say it's a blight. As is the one across the street.